Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making white bean and chicken chili. Now I have several chilies in Betty's Kitchen and they're all different. And this one is the first time I've used chicken instead of ground beef. Also it's the first time I've used white beans instead of something that's more like a pinto bean or kidney bean or something like that. I have done a vegetarian chili if you want to look that up. But today we're concentrating on giving a very flavorful outlook to some white beans and some chicken. So this morning I started my chicken and I decided to make it in a crock pot. And I'll let you see where we are right now because it's been about 5 hours that this has been cooking. I've had it on high and you can see that it is, well, I don't know if you can see, but with my fork, it's very tender, so it may fall apart on me if I try to pick one of these up, but it's definitely done. So what I'm going to do first thing will be to get all of this out and drain it. And you can see it's flaking off like this. I'll be flaking it or chopping it, but I need to get it into little pieces, and whatever that makes, it was probably a little over a pound's worth that I put in there. So if you're comparing it with ground beef or something like that, it'd be about the size of chili recipe that 1 pound of ground beef would make. But we'll put that on a cutting board and either shred it or chop it in order to have our chicken part of the chili. And then I'll show you everything else that gets chopped, and all of it goes together into a pot and it cooks for a little while, and it's going to be a very saucy, tasty chili. We have our chicken all chopped up, and actually instead of chopping it exactly, we maybe made cuts here and there and then used our fingers to pull it. So it has more of a pulled look, and that's much nicer, I think, than to have little cubes of chicken. But as far as the chicken is concerned, this is nice white chicken breast. You don't have to use chicken breast meat totally or at all. You can maybe get a rotisserie chicken that's baked already or rotisseried, and you can just take the skin off if you don't want to use that, and then you can have dark meat and white meat. But you'll need about 3 cups worth. I measured this after it was all shredded, and this is about 3 cups, so that's going to be going into our chili. But what we need to do first is take care of our vegetables. I'll just show you the vegetables we're using. We're using 1/2 of a red bell pepper and 1/2 of a green bell pepper, 1 whole medium onion. All of these are chopped. And then we used garlic about this much. 2, these actually have more cloves in there, but about this much of garlic is minced down here. Now what I need to do is come over here and turn this on, and I'm going to put some extra virgin olive oil in. I'm going to put 2 tablespoons in so we'll be able to sauté our vegetables. So here we have 1 tablespoon and our 2nd tablespoon going in. Now we're ready for our vegetables. So let me just jump back over here and get my cutting board. And I'd like to have this heated just a little bit. So I'm gonna kind of stir that around the bottom. This is a non-stick pan, so it's not gonna stick, but I like to have the bottom completely covered with the olive oil, and I like to have it a little bit hot so that you get something of a sizzle when you put it in there. That may not happen because you saw me just turn this on, but we'll go ahead and put in garlic. Actually, you might want to save that for the last thing to put in because it burns easily, but I'm going to watch this. And then we have our onion and our red pepper and our green pepper. So we'll slide those in, and you hear the sizzle. That's what you need. You want to put it into hot but not smoking oil. You never want your oil to smoke. And I will say that olive oil will smoke at a fairly low point. But just get those in. These are kind of spread out, so it's a little hard to get them across there without some of them wanting to go over the side.
So we may lose a few pieces, but we're pretty much getting there. And I want to give it a stir really bad because I've got that garlic on the bottom. So that's enough, and let's stir it. And we're going to turn it down and saute it gently. And when I get it sauteed until this is nice and clear, I'll come back and we'll put our chili together. And here we have our onion and garlic and green pepper and red pepper. It's all sauteed up. Looks really nice, and you can hear it sizzling there. So it's very hot. What we're going to do is add our chicken. Might as well do that now. It doesn't really have to be in any particular order. This is our approximately 3 cups. Actually, it was 3 half breasts that I put in the crock pot, and I did salt them. I put no water in. I put nothing in other than the chicken breasts and salt. And then I let it go for 5 hours on high, and it was nice and done. It could have gone longer, or it probably could have been taken up earlier. That's the nice thing about the crock pot. It's very flexible. So we have our chicken in there. Now this is going to be white bean, and what I've chosen is Great Northern. So I've got 3 cans, and they're just the standard size can, which is about 15 ounces or so. Usually you'll find these 14 and a half, 15, 15 and a half, something like that. You can use Great Northern beans, or you can use navy beans. There are various types of white beans that will work. Garbanzos won't be very good because they're too crunchy for this. So a bean that can mush down a little bit. In fact, you might mash this a little bit because in some of my recipes, I even put 1 can in the blender just to make it nice and thick. And I think that's a pretty good idea. I just didn't think to do it for this. So we have 3 cans, just standard cans, and they're all the same thing. If you want to mix up the beans, that's fine. If you don't like white beans, use pinto beans, kidney beans, whatever you like. About 3 cans. And this is an ideal recipe for you to make beans on your own if you want. A lot of people comment on they don't like to have things out of a can. Well, since you're doing the chicken early, perhaps in a crock pot, you might have your beans going overnight or soaking overnight and then cooking them, and you'll have fresh beans that are not canned. I have no problem with that. It's just I don't really have time usually to make those beans. I will do that for you sometime. I haven't done that, and I've meant to do beans or lentils or something that is done from scratch just to let you see the process. We used to, when I was growing up, we used to do our own dried beans all the time, so that's all we ever had. So I guess I've gotten tired of that. But anyway, after you get your beans in, then you want to season it up. And I use 2 main spices, which are chili powder. That's a combination of spices, really, and it depends on what brand you get as to what flavor it takes on. And what I do quite often is gather around about 5 different brands and take a little bit of each one, but that's not necessary. I'm just using Maxine. It's pretty good. And then I want some ground cumin seed. Now what I've done here is measure out 2 tablespoons of the chili powder, and I think what I'm going to do is start with about 1 tablespoon. I'm the kind that doesn't normally measure things because I just do it to taste. And when I do a recipe for you, sometimes it's one I've done 100 times at home, but if you ask me how much chili powder I put in it, I couldn't really tell you. I'm starting with 1 teaspoon of ground cumin seed, but again, let's just put like half of that in. And I'm saving these, and I'll be tasting after this cooks for some time. I want the flavor of those spices to get in there. And you can see that this is very stiff, hard to stir, so it's not really like your chili. So we're going to do something about that. What I have is a big amount of water, but I'm not necessarily using all of it. I've put 6 cups in here, so I'll be able to keep track for you. But I'll just pour it until I like to see the water level when I put it in. So we'll stop right there and see if we're seeing the water. I think it's going to take more than that, because we'll leave this at least a half hour, maybe an hour, sometimes two. Depends on when Rick and I plan to eat as to how long this will cook. And it gets better and better when it cooks longer, and it's even better the next day after you've refrigerated it overnight in the refrigerator. So I'm going to add a little more water here. And I don't cover this. I let it just simmer, and then the water boils off and the flavor just condenses down and goes into those beans and into the chicken meat. So let's go to the stove with this. Like I said, you need to see the water. If you can see the water, that's good. And keep this nearby. You may need to add more as you cook this. And the flavoring with regard to salt, since I salted the chicken, and I know that when you open a can of beans like this, it's salted. I'm not adding any salt, but I will taste for salt also. If it needs salt, I'll add salt too. So I'll be checking this and stirring it occasionally. But basically, I'm going to bring it to a boil over medium heat. And then I'll reduce the heat down to low and just let it simmer. Then I'll go watch TV or something for a couple hours, or, well, maybe a half hour, come and stir, check the taste and so on. But I think we're going to have a good supper tonight, and I hope you enjoy it. Here is our finished white bean chicken chili. And I'm saying it's finished after 1 hour of cooking. We had somewhere we needed to go later on, so I want you to know this is really variable. So I just let it simmer for an hour, and I tasted of it a couple of times during the cooking, and I'm going to dip out some for you to let you see what it looks like in a bowl. And if you have always used beef in your chili, you might want to make a change and try chicken, because it tastes very good and you can season it up and it's still chili. And also, if you haven't used white beans, you might want to try that. So I'm bringing this over to my place where I have prepared already, and you've already seen an upload of these Pepper-Jack Cornsticks. So they're great to eat if you want to just take your spoon and eat and have these at the side, or if you want to dunk these in. It makes a really good utensil to eat with. So that's my white bean chicken chili, and I hope you enjoy it.